talk. Well, if this were our personal plumbing system, we'd be on the phone all morning trying to find a plumber, something we may want to do as taxpayers after hearing this story. A new report calculates that broken municipal pipes across the province are leaking enough drinking water to fill 130,000 Olympic-sized swimming pools, and that the cost in wasted water, energy, and environmental damage could be close to $1 billion. Andy Manahan is with the Residential and Civil Construction Alliance of Ontario. His group commissioned the report, and Andy's on the line now. Good morning.
Yes, good morning, Wei.
So take us through the numbers. Can you give us a picture of what it's like city to city in Ontario?
This particular report did not look at individual cities, but there is a range provided in the report that leakage rates in municipal water systems range anywhere between, well, the really good ones are probably just under 10%, and the worst ones are probably 40 to 50%. So when you get to those levels, I would say anything over 25%, that's extremely wasteful.
Mm-hmm. Is it a constant leak?
Well, not quite, no. Obviously, in the wintertime, we have freeze-thaw cycles, and that's when it's more evident that there are burst water mains. But there are certainly some very old pipes. I mean, everyone is aware about the whole issue of aging infrastructure right now, and that's why we're seeing the governments devote money to that, not only as a kind of a recession-fighting tool, but as a city-building tool as well. If I can just point out, though, the interesting part that the University of Toronto civil engineering researchers pointed out was that there are additional energy costs. So when we were presented with this idea late last year and trying to link it with energy, we thought, you know, this is brilliant. There's a new Ministry of Energy and Infrastructure. George Smitherman is responsible for that for the province, and this is kind of tying the two together. So if we can minimize leakage rates, we can also minimize electricity usage, and of course that's a very big priority right now with looking at alternate energy, whether it's solar or wind power and new nuclear plants. So there's a lot of interconnectedness with this whole issue.
Now, I remember in London there was a giant sinkhole that was caused because of the pipes breaking. So just tell us about the condition of some of these pipes. Just how brittle are they?
Well, when we released this report yesterday, we went to a site where they were actually doing replacement of pipes leading into older apartment buildings. And in this particular case, the contractor said to us these were ductile iron pipes, and they were being held together basically by the earth around them. So as soon as he dug, the whole thing crumbled. So basically 60-year-old pipes, that's a pretty good lifespan. So what this report is encouraging is that, you know, rather than wait for those crisis events to happen, and London is of course an extreme catastrophic failure, but let's try to get on top of the asset management program and start doing replacement. Denmark, for example, replaces 1% of their pipe infrastructure yearly. So that type of a target would certainly help across many municipalities in the province.
Now, every homeowner knows that, you know, you've got to keep up on the maintenance or it does a lot of damage later on. And yet, somehow as a society, we put off these repairs.